Does Hinduism promote music and dance for spiritual progress?
Pluralism says you can be spiritual using different modes. You can think of ultimate reality without name, without form as your essential nature, Atman, one way for making spiritual progress. You can think of ultimate reality as a monotheist god if you like, but we recognize the philosophic limitation. But the most exciting part of our tradition, we say you can be spiritual either in a monotheist tradition, on a non-theistic mode, like say Buddhism. You can be spiritual in a non-religious mode. If you take any activity, which we call aesthetic activities, art, music, dance, drama, poetry, literature, that makes you one-pointed and focused. It's not from outside. It's from within, you get a thrill. We are saying you can be spiritual using aesthetic methods, sipping the nectar of spirituality. So pluralism is the power of bridging the gap between many different world traditions, as well as the gap between the spiritual lobby and the secular lobby.
So this is a very different way of looking at it, because that means Hinduism is not a religion.
There are two sets of traditions. Those that came out of Middle East are called the Abrahamic traditions, Judaism, Christianity, Islam. There's a second set of traditions that came out of India, and they're called Indic traditions, Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism. Now, these four traditions are not religions at all. They are called dharmic traditions. What's the difference? Religion literally means realigning human beings with a monotheist God, realigning humanity with a super personality called God. So all the three Abrahamic traditions focus on that. That's their whole enterprise. The dharmic traditions are quite different. They can't be called religion. Buddhism, there's no God. Jainism, there's no creator God. Dharma says we want to make sense of the world that we live in. What is underpinning to this reality? Is there one unity out of which all this diversity is manufactured? We want to come to terms with it. We want to find unity in diversity. This is called dharma. Dhara, what is holding everything together?
So then who is Buddha?
The reason why Buddha is so important is this. In his time, appeasing gods in the heaven, doing animal sacrifice was central. Buddha said, nothing doing, I'm going to stop it. Don't focus on God. Focus on human beings and try and resolve the human condition here and now, not in the hereafter. This is Buddhism. Sorting ourselves out here and now. Dharma. That is why Buddhism is a very powerful tradition. No theos.
So then circle back to the original question of music and dance and all the different creative fields. Basically, we are talking about the need for a single-pointed focus. That's what it's all about?
Any activity that makes you one-pointed and focused gives you a thrill. And the reason is because you are touching base with the underpinning to reality, which is essentially spiritual.
So that means it's a pursuit of thrill with this single-pointed focus is what this is all about.
When I say thrill, the real word that we use is bliss. It's blissful state. Pleasure and pain come in the physical body. The price we pay for the body and the mind. Pleasure and pain are like physical and mental modes that we undergo. Bliss is beyond pleasure, beyond pain. That is your true nature. In reality, we are in search of bliss.
Today we have a rise of fundamentalism. People are irrationally religious. How do they discover their bliss?
The history of humanity shows that only a handful of people were seriously in search of spirituality. Majority are quite easily fobbed off by material gain or name and power and position. There are some people who search for deeper vision regarding their own nature, and they are the one in search of thrill. You first of all chase after pleasure. It takes time for humanity to mature. The maturity comes through a lot of buffeting, getting frustrated and fed up. This is the sign that actually humanity has lost its way, and by trying to discover bliss through pleasurable activities, they're getting stressed out. And when this maturity arises, they then become true, real, genuine searchers. They want to search out nature of reality and their own nature. This is the beginning of the spiritual journey.
When we talk about music and dance for spiritual progress, I'm just curious, how would hip-hop and Bollywood dance fit into this journey?
Okay. Any activity that you do which makes you one-pointed and focused on a deeper vision, that's fine. Any activity that in a way enhances you or makes you feel you are the physical body and not the spirit that is within is considered to be negative. Suppose somebody's down and you go and help him, you lift him up. Why do you say it's good? You're relating to your deeper dimension. You are the spirit, and here is the spirit struggling, and you're giving a hand. You're going back to your roots, your true nature, spirit. That is why it's good. That's why you should help somebody. Suppose you love Bollywood music. Is it good or bad? Think about it. It is not taking you towards your true nature as a spirit. It's taking you to your nature as an animal, not a spiritual being, but purely an animal quivering for gender attraction. And if that is what is drawing you, you're moving away from your true nature as a spirit. That is the only reason why I say not good.
Well, I disagree with you about that because I think all Bollywood dance does not bring out the animal in you. But anyway, I get your point that, you know, it's all about discovering your true nature. So can you explain to me what exactly is this true innate nature of ours?
This is how Kapil started. Who am I? This is what religion should be exploring. Rather than focusing on a god, we say, why don't you focus on yourself? What is your true dignity? You are nothing less than the spirit that underpins this reality. Just manifesting through this body and mind, Upanishads says. Your essential nature is the spirit. It's giving the highest dignity to human beings.